Hello everyone and welcome to another new episode by Engineering Today and back-to-back updates on our favorite topic, SpaceX Starships. Not only that, we'll also like to share some updates regarding United Launch Alliance as well, so stay tuned with us till the end. From the 6th of May 2002, SpaceX started their journey setting a clear goal to reduce the cost and time of space transportation, and to materialize SpaceX CEO Elon Musk's dream to colonize Mars. They've added a number of achievements in its path so far, and now SpaceX wishes to take its pioneering work to the next level. SpaceX is now trying to set up its Starship launch pads upon the chunk of salt. As per SpaceX and Elon Musk, the ocean-based spaceports would be around 20 miles away from their cities. He's given some hint for ocean-based spaceports in the end of 2019 as well. He's hired an offshore operations engineer related to this project from the SpaceX job listing. The idea of building a spaceport on ocean, 20 miles away from the city, somewhat came from the noise problem in airports. People who live near airports can clearly recognize the exploding sound of aircrafts landing or taking off. SpaceX Starships are likely to generate more intense noise compared to airplanes, and because of that, Musk said that spaceports would be set in the ocean, a certain range away from cities to maintain noise levels at their minimum, especially for frequent daily flights. SpaceX builds its Starships to fly 3 times a day, which comes to 1,000 times a year. If they're building the same number of rockets as Falcon, that'll be 20,000 times more compared to the amount of current annual payload. As per SpaceX CEO, 57 out of 100 SpaceX flights took off from the land-based Space Launch Complex 40, SLC 40, located at the north end of Cape Canaveral, Florida, so far. However, the way that frequency of flights has increased, it would require covering a great deal of distance from land. Musk proclaimed that, after completion of spaceport, Earth-to-Earth travel would be super fast. SpaceX Starship can transport 1,000 passengers from one point to anywhere on Earth. Before that, basic test flights would be taken to check if it works as smooth as SpaceX wants. So we may need to wait another 2 to 3 years for the first Earth-to-Earth test flight. So far, so good. Let's get into the next segment now, where we'll be discussing SpaceX's lunar contract updates. SpaceX, with having 5 lunar launch contracts on hand, now has reached an unbeatable place in the global space launch industry. According to the recent information, Masten Space Systems, currently taking its lead on vertical landing technology, has given its lunar mission contract to SpaceX. August 27th at midnight, Masten tweeted, "We've got a ride! We're thrilled to announce our partnership with SpaceX to take Masten Mission 1, MM1, to the Moon in December 2022. SpaceX, apart from Masten's XL-1 lunar lander, still has 4 more lunar landers to launch. In 2019, February, when SpaceX successfully launched Beersheet Lunar Lander under the Israel Aerospace Industries, Beersheet Lunar Lander programs aim to land its scientific instruments along with a digital time capsule, though the spacecraft crashed on the lunar surface as the main engine shut off. The CEO of SpaceX, Elon Musk, is optimistic for the upcoming lunar missions. SpaceX is also building Falcon 9 rockets for iSpace, a private Japanese space company. These launches are scheduled in between 2022 and 2023. Launch under the Planetary Transportation System, PTS, is also in SpaceX's hands, though the German company went bankrupt and their ALENA lunar lander's future is full of uncertainty. In April 8, 2020, NASA's new Commercial Lunar Payload Services, CLPS, planned 4 lunar landing programs. One of them is Masten Space Systems XL-1, which will be the first moon mission of this company. The agency's Commercial Lunar Payload Services actually wanted a partnership with other space companies and aerospace manufacturer for its lunar missions, as this will somewhat benefit their cost. It will also be future-proof for NASA's Artemis program, in which NASA is planning to send first woman and next man to have their feet on the lunar surface. XL-1 moon lander has been in construction for 5 years. Masten says these previous years of work offers one of the advanced and futuristic design with less hardware build. Now, in recent contract, Masten has made some minor adjustments to its structural layout. Apart from that, other systems does not show any sign of modification. Commercial Lunar Payload Services has paid $75.9 million to Masten for this fine piece of work. XL-1 weighs 675 kilograms, that's 1,488.12 pounds, and 2,675 kilograms, or 5,897.366 pounds, full of fuel, is quite large. Masten claims that even with all its equipment and communicating devices, it can offer up to 100 kilograms, 220 pounds of payload on the lunar surface for straight 12 days. After taking Masten's lunar launch contract, SpaceX is planning to land XL-1 lunar lander to the South Pole part of the moon. This mission is mainly concern of the South Pole landing position. Loaded with multiple experimental equipment, the XL-1 lunar lander will observe the conditions and collect all the details it could about the area. In addition, NASA wants to include one of its astonishing inventions, a robotic arm. This high-functioning robotic arm is a modified version of Mars rover parts. Gathered information later will play a key role in NASA's Artemis program, which will be landing on the same part of the moon's surface. Let's see what type of lunar contract SpaceX has with NASA. SpaceX, in partnership with NASA, developing a Starship to send the next man and first woman to the moon in history of the lunar space travel, which NASA named Artemis program. Having invested a value of $35 billion in this program, NASA aims to deliver a better and safe travel for its crew to lunar orbit. NASA's commercial partners will refine their lander concepts through the contract base period ending in February 2021. During that time, the agency will evaluate which of the contractors will perform initial demonstration missions, NASA later stated in a press conference. The gigantic two-stage vehicle, containing a spacecraft and a super heavy booster to lift it out of the Earth's atmosphere, is under process at Boca Chica Beach. Lunar optimized SpaceX Starship does not offer aerodynamic fins and extra heat shield coat. A lunar optimized Starship can fly many times between the surface of the moon and lunar orbit without flaps or heat shielding required for Earth return, SpaceX said. Later, the CEO, Elon Musk, explained, "We're working on new legs, wider stance and able to auto-level, important for landing into wind or landing on rocky and pitted surfaces." Also stated, "No need to bring early ships back. They can serve as part of Moon Base Alpha." Loaded with a number of modifications, SpaceX Starship offers forward thrusters to provide a stable landing on the moon's atmosphere. CLPS will be holding other three lunar lander missions, also having ULA in its list. ULA's two-stage-to-orbit rocket, Vulcan Centaur, which was in development for some years, will take part in this mission. It's decided by CLPS that ULA will take Astrobotic's Peregrine lander vehicle to the moon. For now, this launch is scheduled for June 2021, followed by Astrobotic's Viper launch of Griffin lunar lander in 2023. So, that's what we had regarding SpaceX today. Let's look into some updates from ULA now. United Launch Alliance has launched 40 of Delta IV rockets. 41 is just up ahead. The Delta IV rocket is a heavy lifter, has completed missions for Space Force, National Reconnaissance Office, NRO, and NASA. The Delta IV, once at its orbital test flight, launched NASA's Orion capsule and the Parker Solar Probe to touch the Sun's atmosphere. The launch date was originally one day before the current date, but delayed due to a customer issue. ULA stated that NROL-44 is the first of final five missions to be flown by Delta IV Heavy. The other four, NROL-82, NROL-91, NROL-68, and NROL-70, will be launched before 2024. After that, ULA plans to retire the Delta IV heavy lifter. This 235-foot rocket has two stages. Three main core boosters surround the first stage, each powered by Aerojet Rocketdyne RS-68A with liquid hydrogen and liquid oxygen. It's the world's most powerful hydrogen-fueled rocket engine. All three combined, capable of producing more than 2.1 million pounds of thrust. An ARRL-10B2, a cryogenic rocket engine, using the same liquid fuel as propellant, powers the next stage. National Reconnaissance Office's NRO missions are known as the most expensive and heavy satellite missions that only the Delta IV heavy rockets are compatible. NRO has paid ULA a huge amount of $2.2 billion for five Delta IV heavy missions. Delta IV heavy is a very special vehicle, ULA's director Tony Talanchet said. It was designed to be able to lift the most critical, really big satellites into orbit that can't get any other way. Until now, ULA has successfully completed about 140 missions with outstanding works. As keeping the name of nation's most experienced and reliable launch service, this community is focused on these five missions. After 2024, the NRO heavy missions will be completed by ULA 60% and SpaceX 40%. The rival SpaceX is planning to fly Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy to carry out missions. 2 years ago, SpaceX CEO Musk tweeted, "A fully expendable Falcon Heavy, which far exceeds the performance of Delta IV Heavy, is $150 million, compared to over $400 million for Delta IV Heavy." To keep up with SpaceX, ULA is taking Vulcan Centaur, replacing its Delta IV Heavy. That's all for today, my friends. Hope you liked it. Please take care of yourself and stay healthy. We'll soon come back with more updates. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.